Hey, it's your boy Corey here. Before we get started, go ahead and hit that gray bell for notifications every time a new video pops up, and then also hit the subscribe button. Maybe I said that backwards. Maybe hit the subscribe, then hit the gray bell. Either way, hit them both. But yo, I want to talk to you about examining your circle. You have to examine your circle every so often. You have to just do an inventory of who's around you, who's with you, and who's not with you. We have a circle of influence, and it's tough because we want people around us. It's just human nature. We want people around us. We want to hang out with people, have a lot of friends, be the popular person. And that comes with some good, comes with some bad, some ups, some downs, some highs, some lows. But it's important that you examine your circle. See, your circle is, it's a nice thing to have. It creates some comfort, creates some stability, and it also creates some protection in some ways. But a lot of people get killed from within. You're hurting from within. You hurt yourself within, depending on who's on your inner circle. So we got people out there who are in our circles, and they're well-wishers. They tell us we're doing a great job. They want to congratulate us. They want to give us the pat on the back, the accolades, the hugs. But really, they want to hug you, but they got a knife in their hand about to stab you in the back. They wish you well, but really deep down on the inside, they hate you. They can't stand to see you succeed. They can't stand to see you doing better than them because they've known you for so long or whatever the case is. So you have to examine your circle. Some people say they're friends, but really they're not friends. They're enemies. Maybe they're not flat out enemies, but they're really still not friends. Because, you know, the scripture says a friend sticks closer than a brother. And some of our friends, they're here today, gone tomorrow. And some friends, when it gets real thick, they're nowhere to be found. So that's not a real friend. So examine your circle. There's really three kind of people that you want in your circle, that you need in your circle to help you to succeed. You know, and with these three types of people, it'll help you to develop yourself. It'll help you to develop, it'll help them develop, and it just makes the cycle beautiful for people walking in success. The first type of person you need is someone who's equal, someone who's on the same level as you. We're right here eye to eye. We're able to bounce ideas off each other. We're able to talk on the same level, and everything is beautiful with us. We have this kindred spirit. That's a beautiful thing, because everyone needs that kind of a relationship. It's where I'm not judging you, you're not judging me. I'm not above you, you're not above me. We're right here on the same level, and it helps us to stay connected, stay grounded, and keep us level-headed. You know, those are those kind of people where they'll check you and tell you, look man, that's not right. And you'll accept that, and you won't take that as harsh criticism or that they're rude or they hate you or something like that. The second kind of person that you need in your circle is someone who you're pulling up to another level. Basically, the discipleship, man. You want to train somebody to go up to another level. Maybe you're not training them. Maybe it's a big brother kind of thing. Maybe it's an uncle, an aunt, or whatever, big sister, whatever the situation looks like, somebody who you're pulling to another level. You know, it's sad to see one person go up to another level and the people close to them are still on that same level as before. That's because nobody showed them how to come up. You know, we have in some of our cultures, some of our cultures, parents have horrible credit and they pass that same mentality down to their kids. And then we've got kids who are impoverished, who start out at 13, 14 years old because mom put the power bill in his name or the phone bill in the kid's name or got a credit card in the kid's name. That's horrible. So we need to find people who we can grab and pull them up to another level. This is how our generations continue to be better and better and better. This is how we leave a legacy for those who are coming behind us. You always pull somebody up to the next level. Each one teach one, you know. You reach one, you reach level two, you reach back down to level one and pull somebody else up, and then that propels you to level three, four, and five. But you'll never be better if you don't keep helping other people to grow. That's really the mark of a true leader also. Number three, third kind of person you need is someone who's pulling you to a higher level. The expectation in life should always be to go to another level. We always should be growing. And really, you can't make yourself grow to somewhere where you have no experience. You need somebody who's there to lift you up to that next level, right? Also, those people who are pulling you to another level, they've been where you're at. And they can help guide you through some of the obstacles and some of the battles that you're getting ready to jump into. You don't want to run this thing blind. And so real success comes from learning. You cannot succeed if you don't learn. You know, there's a lot of people who say, you know, I gotta make my own mistakes. I gotta feel my own way through life. That's the most ignorant thing I've ever heard in my life. Look, why keep running into the brick wall if Johnny, who came before you, already ran into that brick wall and can tell you, hey, there's a brick wall right there. Don't run into it because it hurts. It makes more sense to learn from somebody else's mistakes instead of you getting lumped up by your own mistakes. So you need to find somebody who's been where you are, and they can help guide you through the obstacles of life, guide you through the obstacles of the levels where you're at. You haven't been here before. They have. Allow them to mentor you and to really speak into your life and give you some clarity. Look, successful people move, they live within a realm of clarity. You have to be able to think clearly, see clearly, feel clearly. So education is the key. Clarity is the key. Clarity will help steer you to the places where you want to go in life. Look, you know, pride is what keeps these three people out of our lives. We're too proud to be on the same level as somebody. So we always want to act like or think like we're better than everybody else. Pride holds us back from lifting somebody to another level because we're prideful, we're selfish, and we don't want anybody to be on the same level of us because we're competing with other people. And then the person who's above us, we're too proud to submit to somebody else and allow somebody else to just begin to speak to us, speak into our lives, and give us some positivity and even some butt whooping sometimes. Sometimes you need a whooping. I don't care how grown you are, you need a whooping. And you need somebody to correct you and tell you, that's not the right way to do this, because if you do it that way, this is what's gonna happen. I've been there. That's the kind of thing that we need. We need somebody who can speak into our lives and help us to develop, help us to grow. So it doesn't matter if you're a teacher, if you're a preacher, it doesn't matter if you're a speaker, if you're a son or a daughter, if you're an athlete, if you're, it don't matter what you are. If you're trying to start your own business, look for somebody who started their own business already and ask them for some pointers and some tips. Whatever it is that you're doing, find these three people. These three people will help you to make it to that next level in life. So again, I'm Corey Mangum. Hit that subscribe button, hit that gray bell, and then stay tuned for more. Also, share this video with your friends. Share this video with anybody who you can think of who needs to hear this. It's sad to see people who we know who keep dealing with the same dramatic people over and over in life, and all they get in their life in return is drama. Your circle of influence is like an investment, so you're always going to get a return on your investment. So share this video with somebody who might need to hear this same message. Hey, and don't forget, failure is not an option. I love you. Stay blessed. Failure is not an option.